properly like we use, not very much. When you design an application for a grandma, it must be very simple. So you take a grandma, you add a smartphone, and in the result you get very, very, very simple application, which will have, in our case, 6 buttons, because this was the minimal number of buttons I found in user interfaces. Typically, grandma requires only 2 buttons, call and shut down the phone. Yes, you may ask, how is design connected with feedback? I may answer, but the story I'm telling you right now is the real story of John Lee, who is a very well-known user interface professional. So once he was asked to evaluate the application of 2 young fellows who had the same brilliant idea of application for grandmas. John Lee, this is our hero. He gave them the most realistic and the most honest feedback that they asked for, and it broke their thoughts about the feedback. Later, he was saying that what they really wanted wasn't feedback; it was praise, encouragement, or whatever that can make them feel good. Do you understand it? Have you ever felt the same? This gives me an idea, but maybe some people do not really mean feedback in its real sense. They mean, I want you to say that, yes, I am very good. This is what I think most of the people want, of course. So, when we talk about such kind of feedback, we usually talk about instantaneous feedback. And instantaneous feedback, in my understanding, is a feedback like someone had sing a song, and after it, they all clap. This is very easy. No one analyzes the sense of the song. No one says that he took the wrong note in this section. Just, it's okay. This guy is very nice. But what I'm saying right now, that giving feedback in such sense doesn't make any sense. What I'm saying that good feedback always requires time. Why? Because good feedback, in my understanding, requires a lot of observations. It requires a lot of analysis on the work, what was done. But not all the people want to analyze that piece of song or that man playing the violin on the street. No. They just say that this guy is good, but that really makes sense. It doesn't, in my opinion, it doesn't really make sense just to say that this guy is good. So we always have the opportunity whether to say that this guy is very good or not to say anything. And you are always free to choose whether to give this feedback or to not give this feedback. So if you have this choice, you can now apply it to your real life. And whenever you see some person asking you for feedback, you can say, maybe you don't really need the feedback. Maybe you just need to say that you are good, you have done a great job, and something like this. And the last thing I want to say is the following idea. The best one who can really give you feedback is you, because only you can evaluate yourself